Hello, hello.
All right, ready to get started. Welcome to the Thursday edition of Move Well. Today we're going to switch our focus to a group of muscles that, when they give us problems, can make life really tough on us, make it really tough to do a lot of different things. So those hamstrings, that group of muscles behind the back of our upper leg. So we have a series of exercises today that are healthy and you don't have any issues with them, can help you keep them that way. If you do have some discomfort, tightness, or pain, maybe a strain in one of those muscles, these exercises will also help build you back up to being healthy again. So we're going to start with a simple hamstring stretch. Little disclaimer here, any of these exercises, especially if you have some pain or tightness in the back of your upper leg, you want to go through just a pain-free range of motion. So we're going to start out nice and slow. We're only going to go to a point where we feel a mild stretch or feel those muscles in a mild sort of way. We're not going to push into any pain. And if you're otherwise healthy, just go to a range of motion you can control. If you do have a little tweak in that area, again, we're only going to go to where we're going to stop at a point of a mild stretch, but no pain. That's really important. Over time, you can gradually increase your range of motion. For some of these exercises, other ways to progress them will also be to increase the speed of our movement. So today we'll start off nice and slow, controlled. You know what your body's telling you, so please listen to it. So first thing we're gonna do, we're gonna lie on the ground. We're just gonna grab, I'm gonna start with my left leg. Just clasp your hands behind it. Bring that knee up towards your chest. And from here, what we're going to do is we're just going to straighten that leg as far as we can without any pain. We're going to hold it for about 5 seconds. 1-1000, 2-1000, 3-1000, 4-1000, 5. Bring it back down. And we're going to repeat that 10 or 12 times, holding each rep for 5 seconds. So again, really remember, if you're feeling any tightness or discomfort, stop short of that. Even if you don't bend your or straighten your leg all that much, just stop at that point. So here we go. That's two. That's three. Again, you just want to feel a mild stretch, that's all. We're not forcing anything here. That's five. Six. Seven. Stop at 10. We'll grab the other leg. Same idea, just kind of clasp your hands behind the knee. Just kind of bring that knee up towards your chest and then just straighten the leg again through the largest pain-free range of motion you can. Hold it for 5 seconds. You can probably see my right leg here, I have much greater range of motion. My left side, I got a little strain there, so I was only going to a point again and feeling that mild stretch and no pain. Right, that's two. Four.
seven. That's eight, we have a couple more. That's nine. And ten. All right, so next thing now, look at these next couple exercises. There's some good strengthening exercises. I also want you to pay attention to your low back position. We spent a lot of time in these classes working on our trunk and pelvic position. So we want to make sure, again, rib cage, pelvis are facing each other so we can start off with a nice exhale. Settle that low back down. Ribs are down, feeling those abs. I'm going to, again, kind of do the same thing that I just did. I'm going to bring my knee in as close to my body and my trunk as I can. What sometimes helps with this exercise is taking like a tennis ball or even a rolled up towel, putting it in the crease of your hip, and that'll kind of cue you to keep that thigh as close to your trunk as you can. I don't have either of those things with me today, so I'm just going to do my best. So the other leg, I'm going to lift my toes up off the ground, bring my heel in close to my butt. Again, I'm going to set my spine alignment, keep my core braced, try to keep my pelvis nice and level, and then I'm going to push with my heel into the ground to lift my hips up. I'm going to hold it for 2 or 3 seconds. Nice controlled lower back down. Again, keeping that pelvis nice and level. We'll do about 10 of those. That's two. Three. Four, five, six, seven, that's eight. Last one, this side, and 10. So again, it's really important we're using our hips to drive that movement upward, not our back. So again, take that time, set that brace, keep that spine in a good alignment, focus on using your hips. We're gonna switch legs. So bring that one heel on the foreleg in close to your butt, lift those toes up off the ground. Bring that other knee in close to your trunk as you can. All right, again, using your hips, keeping your pelvis nice and level. Drive up. Lower it down. So 2 or 3 second hold at the top. That's two. Three. Seven. Eight. Nine. And 10. So it's going to get a little nasty as you go up in the set. All right, next one we're going to do a glute bridge, something that most people are familiar with, but then we're going to add some walking steps outward and back in. Key here, again, is keep those hips up, fully extended. Don't let the hips or your butt drop down towards the floor. Also, try to keep your hips nice and level. Try not to have them tip side to side. A little bit more challenging as you add those walking steps, so just do the best you can. We're just going to do 6 of those. 2 steps walking out, 2 steps back, lower our hips down. That's 1 repetition. We'll repeat that 6 times. So again, just like anything else, we start by setting our spine. Get that brace, just enough to keep the spine from moving excessively. And from here, we're driving the movement through our hips. So we're gonna bridge up, get your arms out to the side, and then just short little walking steps. Forward, and back, down, reset, bring it back up. Even do 3 steps. If you want, 2 to 3 steps out, 2 to 3 steps back. Keeping that pelvis nice and level. Keeping the hips from dropping down towards the floor the best you can. That's 3. We got 3 more. Bring it up. Good. So those 3 exercises we're going to repeat 1 more time each. And then I have a couple standing hamstring exercises I'm going to show you as well that you can also do at home. Exercises like these, again, whether you have pain or tightness there or they're feeling good, something you can do just to take a little break from your normal daily activities and get those things moving and working a little bit. Here we go. We're going to go back to the stretch. Again, only through a pain-free range of motion. You're just going to straighten your leg till you feel that mild stretch. Wherever that is, that's where you're holding it for that 5 seconds. Another set of 10 per leg. Pass your hands behind that knee. And then just straighten your leg just to that mild stretch. And that's 1. That's 3. That's 4. Five more on this leg. Good. Switch sides. Rest the hands behind the other knee. Just kind of gently bring it up. Hold it in that position. Straighten that leg. Just to a mild stretch. Hold. And relax. That's 1. That's 2. Four. 6. Good. Now we'll go to that hip lift. So again, we're going to bring that knee as close to our trunk as we can. Keep it there. Again, core's engaged, keeping that spine and that back in a good alignment. We're going to focus on driving this movement through our hips, not our back. So bring that heel of the ground leg in close to your butt. Toes up off the ground. Come up. Hold it for 2 or 3 seconds. Lower it back down. It's 2. Side. Then bring that heel in close. Clasp your hands behind the knee. Bring it in tight to your trunk. Again, get that brace. Make sure you're breathing, moving through your hips, not your back. Here we go. That's 1. Again, we're going to get that brace around our midsection, ensuring that we're moving through our hips and not so much our spine. We're breathing, making sure those hips don't drop, or minimize the drop back down towards the floor, and also keep pelvis nice and level. Try not to have it sway side to side if you can help it, and minimize that. All right, here we go. Coming up. Walk it out, short little steps. And then we'll drop it back down, reset between each rep. That's 1. Four. last one. And back out. All right, I'm gonna show you a couple other exercises to do. I'm gonna take my shoes off and just have my socks on for these next two. And you'll see why in a second. Push this mat out of the way. You might want to have a chair handy for this, or if you're at home, you know, in front of your sink or counter in your kitchen, if you have room, is also a great place to do this. So we're basically just going to do a single leg hip hinge. So slight bends in the knee. Almost think about diving off a diving board where we're just going to come forward. Again, shifting those hips back. Same rules apply with this one too. You only want to go to a point where you're feeling that mild stretch. And then we're going to bring it back. So maybe hold it for a second or two. We'll do like 8 repetitions per side. So again, if you have a little strain or tightness or discomfort, you want to make sure you're not going into a painful range. Stop just short of that. Again, one way we can progress these is to gradually increase the range of motion and also the speed of movement. So again, just start nice and easy. If you want to have a chair in front of you, counter, top, if you have bars like these at home, those also work really good too. So again, we're just going to keep our back nice and flat, try to keep your hips nice and level, and then slight bend to the knee on the standing leg, just kind of reach that opposite leg behind you, come back up, tap the floor if you need to for balance. You're just going to a point where you're feeling that stretch in the hamstrings. This left leg, I got a little strain in the back there, so I'm trying to shorten the range of motion so I'm not feeling any pain. You can go to the greatest range of motion that works for you. Do a couple more. All right. Also really good for foot strengthening. It's not the focus for today. We'll go over some of those points at some other time. But great, obviously, for balance, maintaining the arch of a foot, and strengthening the foot and the ankle as well. All right, other leg. All right, good. And the last one, again, best done in your socks, maybe on the floor where you can slide a little bit. So if you have like a linoleum flooring in your kitchen, get next to the counter. So I'm gonna start by sliding with my right leg back. I'm gonna hold on to the bars in this case. Left leg's gonna be my forward leg. This is the leg that I'm kind of stretching out or loading up. So again, for me, a little bit of a strain back here. I'm only gonna go relatively short range of motion, just till I feel a stretch, feel that area kind of loading up and tensing, but no pain.
So what I'm gonna do is, I'm going to slide back with my right leg as far as I can. And then from here, I'm gonna use the bars in this case, or a countertop, pull myself back up. I'm not gonna really use my ground leg here to bring myself back up. So I'm gonna slide it back. These socks are not sliding very good now, but here's the idea. So glide back, pull yourself up with your upper body. Let's do four more. So it's not sliding so good. So you definitely want to make sure you're on the surface, or you can grab like a t-shirt or something that's going to slide pretty good. In fact, that's what I'm going to do. Just happen to have a staff shirt right here. Should slide a little bit better. So again, I'm supporting myself with the bars. Basically loading up the front side as I glide back with the opposite leg. Controlling. And then pulling myself back up with my upper body. Again, 6 to 8 repetitions. This is another one. As it becomes easier for you and you're pain-free, you can increase the speed of the movement as well as the range of motion. Feel these muscles kind of tense up and start to work. Alright, and there you have it. 5 exercises that can help with your overall hamstring health. If you have a little injury now, I would definitely start doing things like this several times a week, staying out of pain, stopping just short of that painful range of motion, gradually increasing the range of motion and the speed of each movement as you're more comfortable doing it. And again, if you don't have any injury there or aches or pains, this is a great way to stay resilient. So hope you liked it. Have an awesome weekend. Give these a try at home several times a week. Let me know how it goes for you. Talk to you guys soon.